Hello and welcome to CAPP123 using Microsoft Access. I'm your instructor Anna Sterling and this video will provide you with an overview of the course and explain how to navigate through it. MSJC uses the Blackboard course management system to deliver online courses. To be successful in this class, you will need to know how to maneuver through the Blackboard interface to submit a variety of assignments. By the end of this video, you will have an understanding of the Blackboard environment, know how to complete the course orientation, be introduced to the different types of assignments and how to submit them, and where to find additional help if or when you need it. Okay, let's get started. When you first log into the course, you will come to the announcements page. Here you will receive information from me about what's going on in the course, at the school, or other important information. Make sure to check this section for new information each time you log into the course. I will post all kinds of info here, from extra credit to scholarship opportunities. The Blackboard interface is divided into three panes. The first pane is the content area, where you see the announcements right now. The second area is the navigation pane on the left side. When you click on items in the navigation pane, the information in the content pane changes. The third pane is the school navigation pane at the top of the page. From this pane, you can interact with your school level options, such as Eagle Advisor. The first week of the course is dedicated to getting situated and learning what is expected of you as a student. So to begin, click on Check-in. This is the course orientation. It is designed to help you understand how this course specifically operates. Some of this information may help you in other courses, but remember these instructions are written specifically for this course and may not apply to your other courses. The goal of the orientation is to provide you with information that will reduce the amount of time you spend learning to navigate the course and increase the amount of time you spend learning the course content taught using these tools. You must complete all parts of the course orientation by 11 p.m. Monday, September 26th, or you will be dropped from the course. The one exception to this due date is the introduction blog post. You must complete the introduction blog post by 11 p.m. September 20th, or you'll be dropped from the course. I'll explain more about that in a minute. Before you begin completing the orientation tasks, make sure you download and read the syllabus and schedule. You will need the latest version of Adobe Reader to view the PDF documents presented throughout the course, so make sure you update using the link provided here. The syllabus outlines what is expected of you as a student and what you can expect from me as your instructor. Make sure you read the whole document. There will be a test. The schedule is a one-page document that shows you what and when everything is due. I recommend printing it and keeping it at your workstation just to make sure you've completed everything that is due each week. You will also want to review my faculty info. If you need or want to meet with me, I am available. However, I'm not full-time faculty, so I don't have posted office hours. I hold another full-time position at the college, so I am around campus, but if you want to meet with me, please email me to schedule an appointment so I can dedicate time to meeting with you. And the last item before jumping into the orientation tasks is to review the book's resources page. This information is provided by the CIS department to help you be successful in all of your CAP, CSIS, and NET courses. You will need the textbook for this course. Please purchase it as soon as possible. Review the textbook section of the syllabus for more details about the textbook requirement. All right, so back to the orientation. If you've taken other online courses, you may be familiar with discussion boards. This course will use the blog tool instead of the discussion board tool to facilitate communication. So the first tool you will learn how to use is the blog tool. You will see that all of the instructions for completing this assignment are listed on the page. Make sure you read the instructions. You'll find that in most of the blog assignments, you are required to do something outside of the textbook or Blackboard to complete the assignment. For the introduction blog post, you will need to create a trading card. Don't worry, all of the instructions on how to do it are here. Once you're ready to complete the assignment, click on the title Blogs to go to the blog access page. From this page, you can select the blog you want to participate in. In this case, the Week 1 Introductions blog. Click on the title to go to the blog. You will see the blog page and the instructions again. You can view other people's blog posts by clicking on their name from the list on the right-hand side. When you're ready to post your introduction, click on Create Blog Entry at the top of the page. This will take you to the area where you can enter your information. There are instructions in the course for using the text editor. Once you have entered your introduction and included your trading card image, you can click Post Entry to submit it. Remember, you must complete the introduction blog post, including the trading card, by 11 p.m. September 20th, or you will be dropped from the course. To return to the course orientation, click on Check-in, again from the course menu, and scroll to the next assignment. The next tool you will learn how to use is the assignment link. You'll be submitting 2 textbook assignments each week, so you need to be very comfortable with this tool. Again, all the instructions for completing this assignment are available here on the page, along with a video link to reinforce how to submit assignments, so I'm not going to go in depth here. Tool 3 that you will need to know how to use is the test tool. You will be taking a midterm and final exam in this course, so you will want to make sure you know how to take these tests. Again, the instructions and a video link on how to take the test are available on the page. When you click on the test link, you are redirected to the Begin Test page. Make sure you understand the instructions before clicking on Begin. You may take the check-in test as many times as you need to achieve a perfect score, which is required to continue on in the course. You will not be able to access any of the weekly assignments if you do not receive a perfect score on the check-in test. Below the assignments are 2 really important pieces of information. Do not skip reading this information. Trust me, I know there's a lot of information here, but that's why I give you the entire first week to complete all of these assignments. I don't want you rushing through the check-in process and then being frustrated or claiming that you were unaware that the course would require so much time and effort later on. Remember, online courses require the same, if not more, time and effort than traditional face-to-face courses. Read the warning section to get a clear idea of what will be required of you on a weekly basis. The Now What area is a review of all the information you should have read and remembered going forward in the course. If any of the info seems foreign, go back and make sure you didn't miss a section. So, once you've completed all of the orientation assignments and received a perfect score on your check-in test, you're ready to go to the assignments area and check out the upcoming weekly assignments. Uh-oh! If you don't see any assignment folders, it means that you have not completed the check-in process, specifically that you have not received a perfect score on the check-in test. Go back to the check-in area and complete the task to gain access to the assignment folders. That's better. After the check-in period closes, you will only need to go to the assignments area to complete your weekly assignments. At the top of the assignments area, you will see some helpful links. The first is a quick link to the blog area. If you just want to check out what's going on in the blogs, use this button to jump there. Next is a link to the textbook companion website. You can download the required data files for your weekly assignments, or get some extra practice in from this site. The third is a resource website I have created for you with all of the content from the course. You can look ahead at what's coming up, view information for weeks that have passed, or bookmark this page as a resource for after the course is over. The last link is a link to the course calendar. The course calendar is just another way to see what is due when. If you scroll down below the course links, you'll see the weekly assignment folders. At any given time, you will have access to the current week and the following week's assignment folders. After the final day of the week, you will no longer have access to that folder. You will read in the course information that I do not accept late work. So removing access to the assignment submission areas is one way I enforce that policy. If you click on the dates of the week, the assignment folder will open. Inside the folder, you will see all the assignments due for that week. I recommend that you start at the top of the page and review the information from top to bottom. It is presented in an order designed to help you succeed at each week's objectives. The first 2 weeks are a little different from the rest, but weeks 3 through 17 will be the exact same format. If at any time you have questions about the course content, what you are supposed to be completing, or access in general, you can post those questions in the Help discussion board. Just click on Help from the course navigation menu. You'll see a link to the Student Blackboard Help website, where you can get all the info you ever wanted about how to use Blackboard. Although, after this orientation, you probably won't need to use it very much because you'll be a Blackboard whiz. And if you scroll down, you'll see a link to the actual Help discussion board. Just click on the link to go to the forum. Once at the forum, you can browse other posts to see if your question has been asked or answered, or post a new question. Simply click on Create Thread to post your question. You can also reply to any questions that are here. I highly recommend working with your peers to resolve issues. Everyone has a unique perspective, and sometimes it may be better than mine. The last area on the navigation to check out is the My Grades area. Here you will see all of your graded assignments and upcoming assignments. If you click on the title of an assignment, you'll see My Comments. Well, that's the introduction. You should now have an understanding of the Blackboard environment, know how to complete the course orientation, understand the different types of assignments and how to submit them, and know where to find additional help if or when you need it. I hope you're excited to participate in the class. I'll talk to you soon.